वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द मल्टीलेयर फीड फॉरवर्ड न्यूरल नेटवर्क. सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द परसेप्ट्रॉन और द सिंगल लेयर न्यूरल नेटवर्क. सो दिस इज एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ योर सिंपल परसेप्ट्रॉन और द न्यूरल नेटवर्क. सो व्हाट ए मल्टीलेयर फीड फॉरवर्ड नेटवर्क इज, द यूनिट्स इन द हिडन लेयर एंड द आउटपुट्स layer are sometimes referred as the neuroids. So your hidden layer and the output layer are actually known as the neuroids. Why? Because their symbolic biological basis or as output units. Fine. So these are the responsible for generating the actual output of the problem. A network containing two hidden layers is called a three-layer neural network. So we have seen in the last class that there is some input layer, some output layer, and there was no hidden layer in the perceptron. But here, if we take two hidden layers, then it will become a three-layer neural network. If there are three hidden layers, then it will become four-layer neural network, and so on. The network is feed forward in that one of the weight cycles back to an input unit or an output unit for the previous layer. So this is feed forward in such a way that your weights of the cycles back to the input to the output of the unit previous layer. So there is something, a cycle, the output become input and input become the output, right? So what are the inputs are record without class attribute with normalized attributes value. So here we will not feed the attributes, we will feed the records without the class name. What is the class? We don't know in the input time. So this is the input vector which have some n number of attributes, x1, x2, xn. So these are the n number of attributes who is going to feed into the neural network. Now the input layer, there are as many nodes as non-class attributes, that mean length of the input. So if there are n attributes, then there will be different n nodes, right, in the input layer. Now coming to hidden layer, the number of nodes in the hidden layer and the number of hidden layers depend on the implementation. So who is implementing that particular multi-layer feed-forward neural network will decide that how many hidden layers is required based on the problem statement, based on the implementation. So the next is output layer. Corresponding to the class attribute, there are as many as node as the classes. So if there are two classes, then there is two nodes, and if there is three classes, then there will be three nodes into the output layer. So it depends upon the how many classes you are having in the problem statement. Network is fully connected, it means each unit provides input to each unit in the next forward layer. So it is a fully connected graph kind of thing. So whatever the neural net, what are the neurons are there, they will also be connected to the next forward layer. Thank you. So we have seen what a multi-layer neural network is. In the next class, you will see the other extension of neural network. Thank you.